to St. Columba's. he gave his only son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life. Since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear friends in Christ, we meet on this day to celebrate Clare's life, the first thing, to celebrate Clare's life. Then we meet to remember that having done those things she ought not to have done, and having left undone those things she ought to have done, we pray that Almighty God, in his infinite mercy, may grant her everlasting light and peace. And we pray in the third instance that we may learn from her example and follow our Lord more closely and more in holiness. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
Oh, has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of his glory in the face of Christ, that we have this treasure in earthen vessels to show that the transcendent power belongs to God and not to us. As we acknowledge our human frailty, we call to mind our sins of word.
Both power and love, forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by the Holy Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. God, our Maker, your creative will gives life to all that is. Your quickening power brings us to birth and raises us from death. Take this, your daughter Clare, into your keeping and give her the new life that is promised in Jesus Christ, our Lord, who once was dead and lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the prophecy of Isaiah. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad. The desert shall rejoice and blossom. Like the crocus, it shall blossom abundantly and rejoice with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it, the majesty of Carmel and Sharon. They shall see the glory of the Lord, the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who are of a fearful heart, be strong, do not fear. Here is your God. He will come with vengeance, with terrible recompense. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then the lame shall leap like a deer, and the tongue of the speechless sing for joy. For water shall break forth in the wilderness, and streams in the desert. The burning sand shall become a pool, and the thirsty ground springs of water. The haunt of jackals shall become a swamp. The grass shall become reeds and rushes. A highway shall be there, and it shall be called the Holy Way. The unclean shall not travel on it, but it shall be for God's people. No traveler, not even fools, shall go astray. No lion shall be there, nor shall any ravenous beast come up on it. They shall not be found there, but the redeemed shall walk there. And the ransomed of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with singing. Everlasting joy shall be upon their heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. The word of the Lord.
reading from the first letter of John. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we shall see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves just as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Oh, Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to Christ.
When they came to the place that is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they are doing." And they cast lots to divide his clothing, and the people stood by watching. But the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others, let him save himself, if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine, and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There was also an inscription above him, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals who was hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus replied, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. when the sun's light failed, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." Having said this, he breathed his last. Give thanks to the Lord for his glorious gospel.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life." Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life." And we carry within us the greatest sign, proof, the truth of Jesus' words. We carry within us the reality of Jesus' resurrection in our tears. Tears consist of two elements: water, the sign of life, health, growth, and flourishing, and salt, the salt of affliction. Our Jewish friends on the night of the Passover have on the table a bowl of salt water, the salt of affliction, the sign of slavery, the slavery of bodily pain, mental suffering, and physical anguish. We shed tears today of sorrow, pain, regret, the regrets, the what might have been if onlys, but remember. Mary Magdalene, in the Garden of the Resurrection, she wanted to visit the tomb of Jesus to weep. To weep and to weep and to weep in grief. And she wept because grief was all she had left of him, the only man who had given to her that most basic foundation of love, dignity. He had given her dignity. And she wept and she wept and she wept because all she had left of him was her grief. But then Jesus said to her, "Mary." He called her by her name, quietly, gently, confidently, "Mary." And she wept. But now her tears were tears of joy. And if you read that story in John's Gospel, it says that Mary turned. She didn't run. She didn't throw her arms around him. She simply turned. He turned her life around. Jesus turned her life around, but gently, quietly, confidently. He called her by her name. He gave her hope, love, new life, resurrection, and she wept. That was the faith that Sister Clare lived. That is the hope and promise that prompted Clare to sing on her deathbed, "Praise my soul, the King of Heaven." That is the faith of the repentant thief on the cross. The gospel Sister Clare chose herself for this day, because the repentant thief knew who he was. He faced himself, the truth of who and what he was, and Jesus gave him the hope, the promise of paradise. The paradise of love we share that makes God real in our lives through understanding, acceptance, warmth, friendship. The love of which our second reading, that first letter from John, spoke today, and which ends, "We are God's children now." Now. Our tears today are tears of grief for all that we have lost. But through remembrance, the love we shared not only continues, but it lives and it grows and it changes. As Clare believed and we believe, she lives and grows and changes now. That is the faith she shared with me. She exuded confidence in God, who is love. To be in her presence, to spend time with her, I always came away renewed in hope. That is the love our Lord Jesus Christ made real, even especially through pain and grief. Love through which the Holy Spirit calls each one of us, calls us to the pursuit of holiness. Holiness not in the sense of I am someone very special, but the holiness of Isaiah the prophet, whose vision of life with God was that God is there with us in every aspect of our lives, even especially in those bits of ourselves we would rather be without. Remember the tears, grief, but hope in love that lives in holiness. Holiness which brings wholeness, healing, integrity. Integrity in the sense of integration of every aspect of our lives, every thought, every feeling, every yearning of our hearts. God is with us. There is the quest for holiness, the holiness of the repentant thief that brings resurrection, the hope of paradise. Whenever and wherever I was with Clare, we would lapse into what Joan calls the Sunderland patois, which has an accent and certain expressions which are exclusive to the northeast of England. And even latterly, by text, we could make each other laugh by the use of certain words and certain names of priests and sisters we had known and worked with, who were deeply, deeply flawed characters. But laughter itself brings new life, new perspective on a place and a world not dissimilar to that of Call the Midwife. Clare and I swapped stories about making our confession to the same confessor. Clare was given as penance the washing of the window ledges in the chapel, which he said he'd looked at for days, and it was time she was less pious, and therefore she could wash the window ledges. He stopped my confession halfway through one time and said, "Kevin, stop trying to make your life sound more interesting than I know that it is. Just make your confession." Clare and I joked that the only office they ever seem to sing in Call the Midwife is Compline. But one of the collects that end that office of the day collects our thoughts, gives us the beautiful expression, "In the silent watches of the night." It is in those silent watches that we gain the real perspective on our lifelong pursuit of holiness. It is in the silent watches of the night that we all know ourselves and are known by God in our very souls. That place where what I think meets what I feel, meets what I most yearn for, that is the place where I know as I am known by God. That is the place where we feel God is with us, through understanding, acceptance by God, who is love. That is the place where the true religious sister, the true priest, is most truly at home with God. That is the place of the discernment of vocation. That is the place from which Sister Clare, religious and priest, ministered and served her community and her congregations. That is the place from which Sister Clare exercised spiritual leadership, servant leadership. And notice I use the word leadership, not direction. My experience of Clare was that in the silent watches of the night she discerned God's Holy Spirit. She discerned the Holy Spirit calls us all to be the people God, and perhaps only God, knows we can be. That is our call, the vocation of each one of us, the cause of our tears. God, who is love, understands what it's like to be you, and understands what it's like to be me. That is the wisdom Clare was able to share, the place from which she gently, confidently led people to God, turned lives around. It was the vision of holiness that literally led Clare and Joan to build Carmel and the Carmel community as a place of vision and common sense. Wisdom indeed in the tears. The repentant thief died in hope, not fear. Fear is the tomb we hew for ourselves out of the rocks of our own personalities. The greatest human fear is the fear of being found out. It was in the silent watches of the night that Jesus left the tomb behind and proved God, who is love, is with us and through his Holy Spirit in us. Love lives as we seek holiness, wholeness, integrity, healing. That is the message of the cross. Love lives and grows and leaves the tomb behind for the paradise of understanding, acceptance, and the call of God. At the beginning of ordinary weekday Eucharists, I use the words every time we hear, God is love. There is no room for fear in love. That is the faith, the confidence, the hope that led Clare to sing, praise my soul, the King of heaven. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Amen.
Let us pray. God of mercy, Lord of life, you have made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for Sister Clare, for the grace and mercy she received from you, for all that was good in her life, and for the memories we treasure today. Hear us, risen Lord, our resurrection and our life. You promised eternal life to those who believe. Remember for good this your servant Clare, as we also remember her. Bring all who rest in Christ into the fullness of your kingdom, where sins have been forgiven and death is no more. Hear us, risen Lord, our resurrection and our life. Your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look in mercy, we pray, on all who mourn. Give them and us patient faith in times of darkness. Strengthen us with the knowledge of your love. Hear us, risen Lord, our resurrection and our life. You are tender towards all your children, and your mercy is over all your works. Heal any memories of hurt and failure. Give us the wisdom and grace to use aright the time that is left to us here on earth, to turn to Christ and follow in his steps in the way that leads to everlasting life. Hear us, risen Lord, our resurrection and our life. May God, in his infinite love and mercy, bring the whole church, living and departed in the Lord Jesus, to a joyful resurrection and the fulfillment of his eternal life. Amen.
Jesus said, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give you. Do not let your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. We meet in Christ's name. Let us share his peace. Look upon us in mercy, not in judgment. Draw us, Lord, from hatred to love. Make the frailty of our praise a dwelling place for your glory. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Worship and praise belong to you, author of all being. Your power sustains, your love restores our broken world. You are unceasingly at work, from chaos bringing order and filling emptiness with life. Christ raised from the dead proclaims the dawn of hope. He lives in us that we may walk in light. Your spirit is fire in us, your breath is power to purge our sin and warm our hearts to love. As children of your redeeming purpose, freed by him who burst from the tomb and opened the gate of life, we offer you our praise with angels and archangels and the whole company of heaven, singing the hymn of your unending glory. Thanksgiving be to you, Lord of all, for by the cross eternal life is ours and death is swallowed up in victory. In the first light of Easter, glory broke from the tomb and changed the women's sorrow into joy. From the garden the mystery dawned that he whom they had loved and lost is with us now in every place forever, making himself known in the breaking of the bread, speaking peace to the fearful disciples, welcoming weary fishermen on the shore. He renewed the promise of his presence and of new birth in the Spirit, who sets the seal of freedom on your sons and daughters. Before he was given up to suffering and death, recalling the night of Israel's release, the night in which slaves walked free, at supper with his disciples he took bread and offered you thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body. It is broken for you." After supper, he took the cup and offered you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. It is poured out for you and for all that sins may be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of me." We now obey your Son's command. We recall his blessed passion and death, his glorious resurrection and ascension, and we look for the coming of his kingdom. Made one with him, we offer you these gifts, and with them ourselves, a single, holy, living sacrifice. Hear us, most merciful Father, and send your Holy Spirit upon us. And upon this bread and this wine, that overshadowed by his life-giving power, they may be the body and blood of your Son, and we may be kindled with the fire of your love and renewed for the service of your kingdom. Help us, who are baptized in the fellowship of Christ's body, to live and work to your praise and glory. May we grow together in unity and love, until at last in your new creation we enter into our heritage in the company of the Virgin Mary, the apostles and prophets, and of all our brothers and sisters, living and departed, through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be to you, Lord of all ages, world without end. The living bread is broken for the life of the world. Lord, unite us in this sign. As our Savior Christ has commanded and taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
Bring us, O Lord God, at our last awakening into the house and gate of heaven, to enter into that gate and dwell in that house, where there shall be no darkness nor dazzling, but one equal light, no noise nor silence, but one equal music, no fears or hopes, but one equal possession, no ends or beginnings, but one equal eternity, in the habitations of thy glory and dominion, world without end. Amen. Father, we commend to your care our sister Clare, giving thanks for all that she brought us. Though now taken from us, let her not be parted from you. May your servant set free from the bondage of earth, be changed into your likeness from glory to glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Go forth, O faithful Christian soul, from this world, in the name of God, the omnipotent Father who created you, in the name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who suffered for you, in the name of the Holy Spirit, who hath been poured upon you. May paradise throw wide her gates to receive you, and may Our Lady, the angels, and all the saints defend you on your journey this day, that your place may be found at peace in the mansions of the blessed, surrounded by those whom you and we have loved so well. Rest eternal, grant unto her, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon her. May she rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen.
Thank you.
the Father, by whose love Christ was raised from the dead, open to you who believe the gates of everlasting life. Amen. God the Son, who bursting the grave has won a glorious victory, give you joy as you share the Easter faith.
Amen.
God the Holy Spirit, whom the risen Lord breathed into his disciples, empower you and fill you with Christ's peace.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
Go.
According to thy word. For mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of thy people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Rest eternal grant unto her, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon her. May she rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen.